We've deployed an e-ICU system to help us deliver tele-ICU services for our organization across all platforms. The core components to it are its own unique electronic medical record and also surveillance tools that we use to help us understand who's sick. In addition to its own unique electronic medical record, it also allows for the ability to have video into each and every tele-ICU room. There are clinical decision support tools built within this electronic medical record that are ICU-centric to help providers understand who is sick and or getting sicker or getting less sick. Typically, we want to focus on those who are getting more sick.
I was approached by Dr. Shoemaker to see if we could help make sure all the medical students got appropriate ICU training when they couldn't even come to the hospital. And I called her like 8 o'clock at night, and I told her, I was like, the patients' families are allowed to see the patients through the screen. The students can use it to see the patients, and then we can do the exams for them and tell them what exams we see. And she was like, do you think the residents would be okay with doing that with the students? And I was like, oh yeah, they're super excited to help out. So that's how it migrated into the students, is I saw family members talking to patients and I said, students can do that too, and they can get good interviews that way instead of just doing chart reviews. Even though the e-ICU can see every patient in every ICU, the family link part is only available in one part of the hospital because the rest need to be upgraded. COVID happened, the upgrade didn't happen. So, because of that, we wanted to allow the students to link in with it safely and securely and HIPAA compliant, so that they could make their questions and we could still do the interviews that way. And I know that my residents were more than willing to do the exams for them and ask questions and stuff. So it actually went over very well. The patients loved it. Because it was only in the HFAM, we were able to adapt it to from the e-ICU to another platform, which Tracy can talk about.
The technology was already there within the CICU or HFAM 7, the upgraded software systems in the rooms, but it was a little known fact that from there we were able to email or text a link to somebody outside the center that it was a HIPAA secure, one-time only use link that they could click on it and then connect into the patient room. And we were using that for our family members on that unit to be able to have interaction with their loved one in the hospital. But we took that idea and applied it to helping our medical students learn.
Dr. Lippold, would you mind just performing some physical exam maneuvers for me?
Of course. What would you like me to do first?
Can you auscultate the patient's chest in all four for heart sounds, please?
Yes, of course. So you can zoom into any part of the room, you can look at what's on the drips, you can look at if they had a ventilator, what's on the ventilator. If they have something come up on their screen that says the nurse in here needs help, they would zoom in and they can do the charting for the nurse. They can watch us do procedures. They can also alert somebody if something's going on in the room that the nurse needs to come in. All through this camera that can zoom in through the whole room. So that's how they normally use this equipment, and it's very helpful, especially when you have a new patient coming in and they have to do so much charting, the nurses do, to make sure everything's compliant. And the nurses are usually busy doing the stuff instead of being able to do the charting, but they have that in every ICU across the board. So just giving y'all a different view because it's interesting to see it in action.
The students were able to connect with the patients virtually through e-ICU. The critical care fellows and some residents helped by facilitating the physical exam as requested by the students. And the students were then able to integrate that information and develop a differential diagnosis and a plan of care. And so overall, even though the students were not able to be physically in the ICU space, they were able to do the tasks that would be typically experienced if they were physically present in the ICU. And they were able to successfully complete their ICU requirement and, of course, graduate then with their class in May.